There's a certain sentiment that Andreas Kling likes to repeat whenever he's asked the almighty "what do you think about language X?" question. I haven't written 100,000 lines in this language, so I don't have an opinion on it, or at least not an opinion that's worth hearing. That's something you don't hear every day, and for reasons that should become clear, I find it weird, though understandable. I've been writing a lot of C++ over the last year. In fact, almost all of my non-embedded C++ experience is from the 10,000 Serenity lines I have contributed in almost 200 commits. You know that this video is titled "Do I Like C++?" And with Andreas' sentiment in mind, this poses another, even more complex question. Do I like C++? And does my opinion even matter? Let's start at the beginning. I have been programming for the better part of 8 or 9 years, starting in high school with Javakara. That's a German teaching tool, basically turtle grid world movement programmed in Java. Given that my total collection of written source code is very hard to piece together, plus most of it was never gitted, plus I know for a fact I've lost 2 major projects, it's hard to figure out how much code I've ever written or edited. So take this estimate with a big grain of salt. Yes, there's PHP in there. I was forced to, I didn't want to. If you sum up the total amount of code I've ever written in my life, you get just over 100,000 lines. By that measure, I am not allowed to have an opinion on anything, not even Java, the single language that I have written the most code in, by far, and the language that I understand best. Java, ah yes, the language that everyone hates, including me, by the way. Here's just a short list of things I dislike about it. But you're not here for that, you're here for C++. So, let's talk about C++. One of my friends expressed it really well. Bjarne Strostrup had some great ideas, but he shouldn't have put every feature he liked into one single language. C++ is bloated, but that's not a new sentiment. Instead, here's my elaboration. C++ has a lot of features that are a good idea, but they are a good idea in isolation. The problem is how these features are put together, more specifically, how they don't actually fit together and still exist inside one language. There's pointers, there's references. Both can be null, some explicitly, some not. Creating a pointer is explicit, creating a reference is not. Dereferencing is explicit for both, lifetimes are not checked for either. There's C-style arrays, which are incompatible with pretty much anything. There's about 10,000 ways to do casts. Many do the same thing or only subtly different things. Some have outright crazy logic, like the C-style cast. There's move semantics and copy semantics, both with specialized constructors and their own behavior. There's at least 5 categories and subcategories of various ways of instantiating a template. There's several categories of values, just values, which determines which of the copy or move semantics apply and what has its destructor run when. There's const expr, const eval, hash define macros. Then there's using, typedef, and still hash defines. Ah, by the way, const expr forces a function to inline, and I'm not going to get into translation unit semantics and the one definition rule. There is no interior mutability with const except when there is. There's initializer brackets, initializer lists, which may or may not be std initializer list. There's assignment initialization, which will probably be different from both. I could probably go on for a bit, plus there's a bunch of things I missed. Generic programming and object-oriented programming are some of the few well-designed and fairly consistent parts of the language. Or maybe I'm saying that because I've never written a Turing complete and or var args template. Who knows? All to say that C++ can be very fun and productive if you restrict yourself to sensible modern features, plus some not so sensible features that you need in very specific circumstances. But at that point, can't you just use Rust with some unsafety? Although you would not be able to guess from my videos, I'm very much a Rustician at this point. I call it my main language in that I don't intend to ever start a new application project in any other language except where appropriate. To me, it's not a surprise that even the Linux kernel likes Rust better than C++, that every major software company is sponsoring the Rust Foundation, and Mozilla just went ahead and literally rewrote parts of Firefox in Rust. If you have the opportunity to look at the past 30, 40 years of programming languages and the use of those languages in practice, you can figure out pretty quickly which errors people tend to make and how we can avoid those errors with good language design. 2/3 of low-level errors are related to manual memory management. How about we throw out manual memory management? I still find it funny that apparently this is something controversial to say, barring the very few instances where any hypothetical borrow checker is not smart enough to figure lifetimes out. Let's get back to the quote at the beginning and what I find so strange about it. I like programming languages. It's one of my second core CS interests besides audio programming. I like to learn about new languages or learn new languages. And at the end of the day, programming languages are a tool. Some are better at certain jobs than others, and not using the best tool for the job means handicapping yourself. I don't consider myself an X-language programmer, even though I kind of implied that before. I'm a Java native speaker, I'm a Rust fan, I'm a C++ audio programmer, I'm a Haskell algorithm developer, I'm a Python scripter and animator, I'm a TypeScript web developer. Struthrup himself uses this in defense of his C++ way too much, but it's true. I dislike fuck ton of things about all the languages I use, especially the ones I use a lot. As for Andreas, I find his view on languages pretty restrictive. Writing that much code means strongly committing to one language, and how are you going to make a comparison that way? Although language knowledge and sound opinion come with experience, it's not everything that validates an opinion. So, do I like C++? No, but I've learned that I can like it enough to comfortably use it. And in the end, that's all that matters for tools. Until next time, goodbye.